and I've got myself a licensed manager for that one night only at Halloween Havoc, and I'd like to introduce him to you right now.
The manager? That's the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Dusty Rhodes at ringside on October 27th. All right, well, that's big news, and
going on here.
Sorry,
I'm sure you don't tell me you're sorry. Just tell me what's going on here.
Hello again, everyone, and welcome to TBS and World Championship Wrestling. I'm Jim Ross, and I'll be your host for the next 2 hours of exciting WCW action, and we've got an outstanding broadcast. Medusa will be here today, and I'll talk to her about a recent altercation she had in Montgomery, Alabama, as she got involved once again with Stunning Steve Austin and Lady Blossom. Plus, ladies and gentlemen, Heavy Metal Van Hammer will make his Saturday night TBS debut here on the broadcast in just a few moments. We've also got an exciting tag team main event. Our main event in this broadcast will feature Cactus Jack and Abdullah the Butcher as they face beautiful Bobby Eaton, and his partner in this event will be the United States Heavyweight Champion Sting. It's going to be a tremendous broadcast. We're also going to have a feature on Big Van Vader, plus our final Halloween Havoc Control Center with Gordon Soley. But right now, fans, let's go to the ring. Get ready for Heavy Metal Van Hammer.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest on World Championship Wrestling. It is set for one fall. Introducing first from New York City, weighing 290 pounds, Heavy Metal Van Hammer. His opponent from Los Angeles, California, 264 pounds, Step Iron, Bill Orr.
Heavy Metal Van Hammer making his center stage debut here, everyone. Big man, 6'7", maybe 6'8", 290 pounds. Included in the tremendous lineup tomorrow night at the UTC Arena, the site of Halloween Havoc 91. And we are 24 hours away, and Scrap Iron Bill Ford, last week a real tough brawler, trying to gain an early advantage. He was really whipped into the corner. High elevation. Van Hammer getting that near 300 pounds up in a drop kick. Very impressive physical specimen here. Flying shoulder block. Heavy Metal Van Hammer. Get the crowd involved. Very charismatic athlete. Van Hammer with that front face lock. Got Ford up, and right there, what time is it? It must be Hammer time. Heavy Metal Van Hammer wins it decisively.
Here's your winner, Heavy Metal Van Hammer.
Heavy Metal Van Hammer rocking his way to a very conclusive victory here at center stage in Atlanta. Don't forget, fans, tonight in Knoxville, 8 o'clock at the Civic Auditorium Coliseum. Live WCW action tonight at 8 in Knoxville. And there you see, indeed it was Hammer time. Fans, when we come back, we'll be joined by the Dean, Gordon Soley, and our final Halloween Havoc Control Center. We'll be right back.
Gordon Solie, and this is Halloween Havoc Control Center. Well, this is the weekend we've all anxiously anticipated, because this Sunday night, exclusively on pay-per-view, it's Halloween Havoc 91. You still have time to call your cable company and order this spectacular but mystery-filled event for the entire family. 11 bouts have been signed for Sunday night's pay-per-view. The events include 4 championship matches, The Unknown, the first-ever Chamber of Horror steel cage match. In addition, we will hopefully find out who are the creatures and the WCW Halloween Phantom. Now, here's a look at the entire lineup.
It's Halloween Havoc, only on pay-per-view, Sunday, October 27th, 7 o'clock Eastern Time. Johnny B. Badd goes one-on-one against Jimmy Jam Garvin of the Freebirds. Beautiful Bobby will take on Terrence Taylor of the York Foundation. You'll see PNU's The Ratmaster and Big Josh face the Creatures. Heavy Metal Van Hammer goes one-on-one against Michael P.S. Hayes for the World Tag Team Championship. The Enforcers defend against the U.S. Tag Team Champs, the Patriots. The Z-Man takes on the mysterious WCW Halloween Phantom. Finals of the WCW Light Heavyweight Tournament. Flying Brian against Richard Morton of the York Foundation for the World TV title. Stunning Steve Austin against the Natural Dustin Rhodes. The World's Strongest Man, Bill Kazmaier, faces Cactus Jack. It's the Chamber of Horrors. 8 men on 2 teams. Elegante, Sting, and the Steiner Brothers against Oz, Abdullah the Butcher, the Diamond Stud, and Barry Windham. And 2 out of 3 falls for the World Heavyweight title. The Total Package, Lex Luger, against the All-American Ron Simmons at Halloween Havoc.
I am especially interested in the battle for the WCW World's Heavyweight Championship, with a 2 out of 3 falls stipulation between the Total Package Lex Luger and the All-American Ron Simmons. Never before in WCW has two more gifted athletes with magnificent football backgrounds met for the sport's most prized title. Lex Luger, a 3-sport high school all-starter, recruited by Coach Joe Paterno at Pennsylvania State and played for the Miami Hurricanes, then in the CFL, the NFL, and USFL as an offensive lineman. Ron Simmons, on the other hand, was recruited by Coach Bobby Bowden at Florida State University, where he ranks as the Seminoles' greatest defensive lineman of all time. The consensus All-American finished in the top 10 in the Heisman Trophy race as well. Now here are some comments from the challenger and the champion.
This Sunday night, the nation will finally get to see two athletes that match up in strength and size almost identically. At Halloween Havoc, Lex Luger, I'm gonna be at my best. And you know what Ron Simmons is capable of. You played opposite of me playing professional football. You tried clipping me out of 4 downs, holding me. This Sunday, it'll be 2 out of 3 falls. You can try anything you want, brother. Kick, punch, snap, anything you want. When I put your back on the mat for the 1, 2, 3, the whole world is gonna rejoice in my victory.
Halloween Havoc. This Sunday night, all the talking, all the posturing, all the contract signing, it's all done with. What it comes down to now is who is the greatest wrestler in the world today. The Total Package, Lex Luger, the world's heavyweight champion, the measuring stick in professional sports today against Ron Simmons, the All-American, all his football, his everything, culminates in Halloween Havoc. This Sunday night, you get your chance, Ron, to realize your dream in 2 out of 3 falls.
I expect one of the most physically intense struggles ever witnessed on pay-per-view television between these two magnificent competitors. Remember, WCW has barred Mr. Hughes, Luger's bodyguard, from ringside during this event. Harley Race will remain at ringside because he has a WCW manager's license. Ron Simmons, as many of you now know, will have the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, as his manager for the night. I truly feel Dusty will neutralize Race, and with Hughes gone, this title confrontation will be decided one-on-one. As my colleague Jim Ross said recently, the playing field is now level. Indeed it is, and this Sunday night at 7 p.m. Eastern Time, exclusively on pay-per-view and the Wrestling Hotline, Lex Luger and Ron Simmons decide the richest prize in WCW in a bout that I'm sure will be discussed for years to come. You still have time to call your local cable company and order Halloween Havoc 91, if you dare.
Ladies and ladies and gentlemen, the following contest on World Championship Wrestling. It is set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied by the executive director of the York Foundation, Alexandra York. He's from Nashville, Tennessee, weighing 212 pounds, Richard Morton. His opponent from Baltimore, Maryland, 227 pounds, Jumpin' Joey Maggs.
Jumpin' Joey Maggs to challenge Richard Morton of the York Foundation. And of course, tomorrow night at Halloween Havoc, Richard Morton, I think, is the odds-on favorite to win the WCW Light Heavyweight Championship. You were with us last week. York Foundation involved in a six-man tag team event that did not feature Flying Brian. Flying Brian's arm in a sling here last week. We understand for you Flying Brian fans that he is at or near 100%. And his doctors think by tomorrow night he should be ready to go. But Morton is a great veteran. A man that has amassed one of the most phenomenal one-loss records in tag team wrestling. Great success in tag team wrestling. Can he transfer that to a one-on-one environment, specifically tomorrow night? Joey Maggs was in the WCW Light Heavyweight Tournament in the very early stages. And this youngster has a great future ahead of him. And now that WCW is establishing a light heavyweight division, I think we're going to be hearing much more from this likable youngster from Baltimore. Good shoulder block, and Joey Maggs going for a pin. Morton kicked out at two. Had a conversation earlier today with Alexandra York about tomorrow night, Halloween Havoc. And by the way, all day today until midnight tonight on the Wrestling Hotline, I'll have my predictions. As a matter of fact, at 9 o'clock tonight on the hotline, Lance Russell and Gordon Soley will have a Halloween Havoc preview. So you can call and get my predictions until 9, and then call back at 9 and hear from Gordon and Lance as they analyze tomorrow night's pay-per-view spectacular. But Ms. York really feels that she's got a computerized game plan that is infallible. One would assume that due to the injury to the shoulder of Flying Brian, that will be the focal point of that match. Or at least that is what we could assume. As I mentioned, Morton may keep us off balance because she was very closed-mouthed when I asked her exactly to tell me more about the game plan. She feels very, very comfortable that the York Foundation will be holding the first championship. Good move there by Jumpin' Joey Maggs, in very deeply with the arm drag takeover. Now a scoop slam. And Morton's going to roll out of the way. This is not the tune-up match that Richard Morton and Alexandra York envisioned, I am sure. I'm going to be talking a little bit later in the broadcast to Barry Windham, and I'm going to ask Barry a question that many of you fans have asked me, not only when I see you in person, but on our radio program on AM 750 WSB on Sunday nights as well, is why is Barry Windham a member of a team that includes Abdullah the Butcher, the Diamond Stud, and Oz? Near fall situation, and Morton countered into the head scissor. Use a little hair there, it would seem. A lot of people are wondering about the Chamber of Horrors and the first match of its kind in history on pay-per-view television tomorrow night at 7 o'clock Eastern Time. It's a 7 p.m. Eastern Time start. And you still have time to call your local cable company and be a part of it. I've tried my best to find out who the creatures are and who the WCW Halloween Phantom is. No luck, unfortunately. Side headlock, good takedown by Joey Maggs. And a straight right hand. Joey Maggs with a lot of fire in this contest. Oh, But that will certainly put fire on the coals. The fire is no longer burning. And Richard Morton now, let's see if he will accelerate it a notch or two. Right hand, right to the solar plexus. And now the foot right to the throat. Referee Randy Anderson exercised his count. Morton did not want to be disqualified. He did break it. One characteristic of a light heavyweight bout is that they are very fast-paced and very offensive-minded. And we may find ourselves in a situation tomorrow night at Halloween Havoc where Morton and Pillman, the winner may come from the first man that can capitalize on his opponent's mistake, because I really believe that there are going to be a lot of high-risk moves attempted in the contest. But right now, I'll give you a little preview. I really think that Morton has the advantage. And I think we may be watching the first light heavyweight champion in action right here. I mentioned earlier that promoter Bob Polk has got a big card tonight up in Knoxville. 8 o'clock starting time at the Civic Auditorium Coliseum, as we look over the shoulder of the Brain Trust behind the York Foundation, Ms. Alexandra York. Nice reversal there. And Joey Maggs couldn't take advantage of it. He suplexed. A lot of authority and velocity by Morton. And now Morton, the lateral press. And Joey Maggs barely got his foot in the ropes there. And we found out last week that Mr. Hughes would be barred from ringside during the match between Luger and Ron Simmons tomorrow night. Dusty Rhodes has a one-night-only referee's license. He'll be in Ron Simmons' corner. So as I mentioned last week, I think Simmons and Luger are going to compete on an even playing field at Halloween Havoc in that big 2 out of 3 fall epic on pay-per-view tomorrow evening. We heard those comments from Luger and Simmons in the Halloween Havoc Control Center, and it's obvious that both those fascinating athletes are ready to go for that one. But as important as that match is to those two men, the WCW Light Heavyweight Championship is just as important for Alexandra York, Richard Morton, and Flying Brian Pillman. Maggs fights back with a right hand, caught Morton coming in. Morton now opening up. Morton using Maggs for a punching bag, hammering away. There's an Irish whip. And Maggs caught him coming in again. Morton dropped his left, and Maggs has gotten that right in 2 or 3 times. You got to hand it to this youngster from Baltimore. A great wrestling city promoted by Gary Juster. Great WCW action at Baltimore Arena. And there's a big move by Jumpin' Joey Maggs. Hey, he's going for the upset here. This is his championship match, if you will. But Morton Cutting coming out of the corner. He nailed him right in the nose. And now Morton up on the top turnbuckle. He'll place his left knee in the back of the kid's head and drives him right to the canvas.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Richard Morton.
Exclusively on pay-per-view. Approximately 24 hours away, Richard Morton and Flying Brian will decide who will be the first WCW light heavyweight champion. Morton placing that knee into the back of the youngster's head, drives it straight down. Mm-hmm. That certainly should be a great matchup involving Richard Morton and Flying Brian at Halloween Havoc for the WCW Light Heavyweight Championship. But now I'd like to introduce a man that also needs to answer a very puzzling question. I'd like to introduce at this time the man from Sweetwater, Texas, Barry Windham, here to center stage. You know, fans, one of the big mysteries at Halloween Havoc surrounds the Chamber of Horrors steel cage matchup. On one side of the ring will be the Steiner brothers, Sting and Elegante. But on the other side of the ring, you will find Abdullah the Butcher, Oz the Diamond Stud, and Barry Windham. My question to you, Barry, why are you on the team led by Abdullah the Butcher?
Well, really, that was supposed to be a secret, but I guess if I tell you, I may as well tell everybody here. Now, have I ever walked out here with Abdullah the Butcher and done an interview or been in a match with him, called him my friend?
No, sir, you have not.
Well, have I ever stood out here with Sting and had him right by my side? Have you ever been out here with Oz? Have you ever been out with any of those guys that are supposed to be on my team?
Not to my recollection,
no. Well, I'll tell you what. This match is supposed to be one of the most dangerous in WCW history. And it's one of the kind of matches where only one person is going to really feel the shock of the whole thing. It's going to be an electrifying match, and I guarantee you I'm not going to be the one that gets the shocking ending. So that's all I'm going to tell you, and the rest is a secret. I don't want it out.
Interesting comments from Barry Windham. Perhaps the only way we'll ascertain the answer is by calling your local cable company and joining us on Halloween Havoc. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back on TBS after this. Welcome back, everyone, to TBS and World Championship Wrestling. Jim Ross back with you, reminding you that still to come, our main event, Sting and Beautiful Bobby to take on Cactus Jack and Abdullah the Butcher. That match coming your way just a little while here on the broadcast. Now, ladies and gentlemen, a man that certainly is no stranger to any of you wrestling fans, he is Big Van Vader, and he's on his way back to World Championship Wrestling. Big Van Vader, a man that has held championships around the world. He has been a champion in Japan. He has been a champion in Mexico. He's been a champion in Europe. And Big Van Vader is on his way back to World Championship Wrestling. This 400-pound athlete, one of the most bizarre individuals, one of the most sadistic individuals we have seen. In some circles, we have seen Big Van Vader a fan favorite. But most of the time, the big man from parts unknown would prefer to wrestle by his own rules. Here's a special video feature on the returning Big Van Vader.
Welcome back, everyone, to TBS and World Championship Wrestling. Last week on the broadcast, in the television championship matchup featuring Stunning Steve defending the title against PN News, we saw Lady Blossom pass Stunning Steve some type of object. Well, Stunning Steve used that object quite proficiently. And as Lady Blossom put it back into her dress, we knew that she had something concealed. Dustin Rhodes came to the ring. He didn't want to search her, but Medusa followed Dustin to the ring, and here's what happened.
There. And now look, just like last week, those brass knucks, or whatever they are, Lady Blossom gave him the PN News, and he just got his lights dimmed. And Austin will win it all.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner and still World Television Champion, Stunning Steve Austin.
Well, Dustin Rhodes, who a kid that believes in fair play, and what's right is right, and what we have just seen isn't right. And he's telling the referee that she has put that object back in her dress. And wait a minute, here comes Medusa. She just shoves Dustin out of the way. She's going to search, and she found it. There they are, the brass knucks. Referee's going to reverse the decision.
Now, because Medusa found the object, Stunning Steve was disqualified, and PN News was declared the winner of the match via disqualification. Stunning Steve retains the television championship. And then recently in Montgomery, Alabama, Medusa followed Stunning Steve and Lady Blossom to the Civic Center there, as Stunning Steve was set to defend the television championship against Mike Graham. We want to show you this match in its entirety, and especially watch the closing moments when Medusa made another appearance.
And the bell sounds here, the World Television Championship on the line. The former junior heavyweight champion of the world, Mike Graham, challenging Stunning Steve Austin here. Nice fireman carry takeover. Driving the knee into the bicep and tricep area is Mike Graham. And now the arm bar, the wide base. Boy, Graham's a real wrestling machine, is he not? Graham certainly from a family rich in wrestling heritage. Son of the late Eddie Graham. We have mentioned before, fans, especially in the state of Florida, familiar with that name. And right there's the hole. That's almost a family trait, the figure four. And Austin knows that full well. Cannot afford to find himself in the figure four. Boy, last week on WCW, Saturday night, the very bizarre Medusa got involved in Stunning Steve and Lady Blossom. Right there's a cradle and a near fall situation. Boy, this Sunday night's Halloween Havoc event would certainly be changed if Austin loses the championship here to Mike Graham. And don't think that couldn't happen. Hey, Graham has backed down a lot of big men in this wrestling sport. You just wouldn't believe some of the big guys that don't want to have any part of Mike Graham. And Austin pulled the hair there, got Graham in the head scissor. Want to remind you fans that we have some very interesting predictions on Halloween Havoc that you can hear right now on the Ross Report on the Wrestling Hotline. I've got some late-breaking injury reports. Some of the matches have been changed a little bit, and you can hear all the latest on Sunday's Halloween Havoc event on the Wrestling Hotline. As a matter of fact, at 9 o'clock tonight, Lance Russell and the Dean, Gordon Solie, will have a special Halloween Havoc preview program. So a lot going on the Wrestling Hotline here today. Great move there by Graham. Boy, he is highly skilled in counters and great defensive wrestler as well. Austin quite upset that his hair was pulled, but he pulled it first, so I don't know what that means. What cliche should we use? How about none? Side headlock by Stunning Steve. But Graham doesn't stay there long. But Austin has the size advantage here. About 40 pounds bigger than Graham. And that leg grapevine there. That nature boy Buddy Rogers really perfected many years ago. Found it most interesting last week when Medusa came in. I said at the time that I didn't know if Medusa was an ally of Dustin Rhodes or an enemy to Stunning Steve and Lady Blossom. I don't know that she's an enemy more than we saw, but one thing we know, that she is not an ally, speaking of Medusa, to Dustin Rhodes. Very complex lady is Medusa. We still don't know exactly why she's here, quite frankly. Good chop there by Graham. Really great strategy applied here. It's very simplistic, but very effective. Graham fully realized that Austin is stronger than he is and has more body mass. So consequently, he's going to negate that. He's going to lessen that advantage by taking Austin off his feet and mat wrestling him. Graham's got a great amateur background, and he grew up in Florida in an era of tremendous wrestlers like Jack Briscoe from Oklahoma State University and Dory Funk Jr. Both former world champions. And both those guys, by the way, weighed about 235 to 245 in that category. Certainly a misnomer that you've got to be, you know, 300 pounds to be a great wrestler. That's ludicrous. Matter of fact, I think many fans enjoy matches of this type than those matches where there's two 300-pound guys with this. It's like two refrigerators or two guys, you know, just running their bellies into each other. People want to see, I think, competitive matches with a lot of movement, displaying a lot of strategy. And that's what we're seeing right here, as a matter of fact. Graham held on to the leg there. That is his focus. And now he rams Austin to the turnbuckle, keeping him confused a little bit. Knee right to the collarbone. He's going for a pin, and Graham's not wasting any time. He realizes that Austin has got to be thinking about Dustin Rhodes this Sunday night at Halloween Havoc. Austin has had his share of problems with young Mr. Rhodes in the last several weeks. So what an opportune time for Graham to upset Stunning Steve. And on the eve of Halloween Havoc, Mike has really been instrumental in the accelerated development of Flying Brian. Graham's almost been like a big brother, a mentor figure to Flying Brian. Of course, Flying Brian has a chance to be the first WCW light heavyweight champion at another one of the future events at Halloween Havoc. Austin in the ropes. Referee calls for the break. He gets a clean one from Graham. Side headlock into a hammerlock, into a single leg pickup. He really is keeping Austin off balance. And Austin rakes the eyes. So Austin noticeably limping now, ramming Graham's head into the top turnbuckle. Slip, but he caught him coming in. Good knee. Now Graham capitalized. He's going for the pin and got 2.5 out of it. And Graham back to work tenaciously. With a pit bulldog-like tenacity, Graham is really mat wrestling Austin here on WCW. Some very interesting articles have been written recently about Stunning Steve. Some very unique things in the current issue of WCW Magazine. Without a doubt, WCW Magazine is the absolute best wrestling magazine in the world today. And it's available by subscription and, of course, on newsstands throughout the country. Austin in danger of being pinned here, and I tell you something, this Graham has wrestled a very, very intelligent man. Austin concentrating on that, on the pain in his leg, forgetting about his shoulders there.
How about it?
No, no.
How about it?
And again, Austin uses a blatant rule-breaking tactic, raking the eyes. And Lady Blossom, for some reason, up on the apron there. Graham, well, what a devastating situation that was. Referee, well, was talking to Lady Blossom. I think that's her purpose out here. I don't know why they even allow these valets and managers at ringside. They should do their work before the match. You know, the coach doesn't go out in the huddle and stand behind the quarterback when he runs a play. Oops, I'm not supposed to talk about football. Sorry about that. But look at Lady Blossom now. She's got that high heel, that spike there. And again, Graham rammed into the security railing. The tempo has slowed down to a pace now that Austin is dictating. And Graham unable now to continue working on the leg. But he picks that leg right there. Well, I'm wrong again. Graham wrapping it around a steel ring post. Well, I'll tell you something. Austin is in danger, quite frankly, of losing the television title. And if he does not lose the television title, his knee and his leg are going to be extremely sore. And that's going to make him very vulnerable at Halloween Havoc when he takes on Dustin Rhodes for the television title. At least that's what is scheduled as we speak. Graham the snapmare and got two out of it. Austin up with a vicious right hand and throws Mike out again. Keep your eye on that blonde woman trying to hit him in the head of that shoe. That's not going to hurt Mike, but it just aggravates the heck out of you. But what it does is get his attention on her and not on Austin. Graham tossed back inside. And now Austin turns it up a notch. Great suplex by the television champion. And Austin now, well, he's going to take a chance here up on top. But Graham pulled the knees up. Now can Mike take advantage of it? He's got the opportunity here to get back on the offensive. Right hands by Graham. Austin now in a vulnerable position. He's elevated. And it's Mike Graham. He's got him in the figure four. And what's she doing? Lady Blossom gave Austin that object, those nooks or whatever it is. He just hit Graham in the face with it. And he's handing it back. Wait a minute. There's Flying Brian. And Lady Blossom just put those nooks back into the top of her dress. And nobody wants to search her. Wait a minute. But there's Medusa back here. She shot Pillman out of the way. And she's going to take it right out of the top. Now, ref, there's your evidence. The decision will be reversed. Mysterious Medusa has struck again.
For disqualification, Mike Gray.
The following tag team event, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from the North Woods, weighing 270 pounds, Big Josh. His tag team partner from Motown, 403 pounds, the Rapmaster, PN News.
Fans, we're going to hear a rap here. I would assume it's going to be a rather unusual rap. Let's go back up to ringside.
I've got a rap that's fresh, so let's put it to the test. When this rap is over, the posse knows what's best. Our tag team is the toughest, of that there is no doubt.
And when this match is over,
hear the posse shout, yo baby, yo baby, yo!
Yo baby, yo baby, yo!
I said yo baby, yo baby, yo!
Yo baby, yo baby, yo!
All right, Big Josh!
And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents, total combined weight, 534 pounds, from Northport, Florida, Bob Cook, and from Boise, Idaho, Fred Avery.
Well, I appreciate their effort in the rap, but I think Big Josh better keep to hunting and fishing and wrestling. Those are the three things that I know conclusively that he's the best at. And these two guys, Big Josh and PN News, will take on an unknown team known only as the Creatures at Halloween Havoc tomorrow, 7 o'clock Eastern Time. Bob Cook starting out, and Big Fred Avery in there, and he'll never wrestle in the light heavyweight division. And PN News with a double clothesline, God headlock on Big Fred Avery. Scoops him up. Avery's well over 300 pounds. And PN News rolls right through the competition. And Big Josh doing a log roll. Just nailed Bob Cook. Well, I don't know who the Creatures are, but they better come ready to fight. Because PN News and Big Josh, I think, are going to be a very formidable challenge for anyone that steps in the ring with them. We'll have our predictions all day, well, I should say until 9 tonight on Halloween Havoc. And then at 9, Gordon Soley and Lance Russell will have a very special Halloween Havoc preview show. That's at 9 Eastern tonight on the Wrestling Hotline. Of course, you fans that cannot get this event on pay-per-view and cannot be with us in Chattanooga at the UTC Arena, you can hear the event live as it happens on the Wrestling Hotline. That'll start at 7 o'clock Eastern Time tomorrow night. So just don't be left out. Be a part of Halloween Havoc any way that you can. Big Josh with big chops, nailing Bob Cook, who's an outstanding wrestler. Belly to back suplex. You know, fans, I must digress a moment. Medusa has struck again. And we saw her last week. We do not know her motivation, but we will try to find out her motivation, because I'm going to be talking to her a little bit later in the broadcast. There's a drop kick by PN News. 403, and now these are some heavyweights now. It's almost sumo time. We saw hammer time. And the impressive heavy metal Van Hammer beat Halloween Havoc as PN News hammers rights and lefts, and down goes Avery. Knee to the midsection there by PN News. Fans, don't forget our main event. Sting and Beautiful Bobby take on Cactus Jack and Abdullah the Butcher. That match is still to come in this broadcast. Ouch! Ouch! The southpaw from the North Woods looking really good. Makes Avery monkey flipped him right out of the corner. those logger boots feel real good on your face. Camel clutch applied by Big Josh. Working on the neck and the lower back of Fred Avery. With a submission move. Mike Atkins, great position there to get the submission, but Avery hasn't given it up. Forearm there. And he locks that belly-to-belly in. Great wrestling move by Big Josh, and he makes a tag to PN New. And we know what this is. The biggest broken record. Creatures or no creatures, who can withstand that?
Gentlemen, the winners of the match, the team of Big Josh and the Rep Master, PN News.
Like so many of the questions that will be answered tomorrow night, PN News and Big Josh wondering who the creatures are, and we'll all find out together tomorrow night at Halloween Havoc.
The following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Auburn, Alabama, weighing 334 pounds, the world's strongest human being, Bill Kazmaier. His opponent from New York City, weighing 271 pounds, Lou Fabiano.
Kazmaier and Fabiano. Here on TBS, welcome back, everyone, to World Championship Wrestling. Jim Ross back with you. Thanks for being with us. Fabiano raking the eyes of the strongest human being in the world today, Bill Kazmaier. And he's got that huge arm locked around the rope. Came off with a short shoulder block, knocking down Fabiano. Fans up. Still to come, we're going to show you an altercation involving the Enforcers and the Freebirds that my good friend Gary Michael Capetta was very close to. We'll have that for you a little bit later in the broadcast.
Hey, break the hold there.
I'm going to be talking to the mysterious Medusa in this hour. And our main event still to come, Sting and Beautiful Bobby to meet Abdullah the Butcher and Cactus Jack. Kazmaier has a full Nelson on Fabiano. And that's like, that'll be like having your neck in a vice. Broke it all right. Fabiano got in the ropes. Kazmaier just let go of it. Kazmaier with a fireman carry takeover. He's a power wrestler. There's no doubt about that. And Cactus Jack may taste that, just how powerful he is tomorrow night. Shoulder block by Kazmaier. We saw Kazmaier last week and Cactus Jack, and I think he had him beating that bear hug. And now he's got Fabiano up in a bear hug. Fabiano's near that 300-pound mark, and he's just crushing those ribs, that's all.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, the world's strongest human being, Bill Kazmaier.
Well, this one ended rather quickly. I think we've got time to talk to Kazmaier. We're going to try to do that here in a moment. We take another look. There's a shoulder block. It's like being ran over by a truck. And there is the bear hug, the difference maker.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Big Bill Kazmaier, Cactus Jack at Halloween Havoc. Bill, I know you've got some thoughts about that matchup with a very reckless athlete.
Well, Cactus Jack's a little bit crazy, but I'll give him a little bit of what I just gave this fella right around the waist and see if he can handle that.
Bill, all the eyes will be at Halloween Havoc tomorrow night. Two out of three falls for the heavyweight championship of the world. What are your impressions about this matchup 24 hours away with Lex Luger and Ron Simmons?
Well, I can't wait to see this one. I know Lex Luger, he's the best in the world. The total package, I've seen him train, I've trained with him. He's in a spot to win. But Ron Simmons, a totally different story. A man with a dream, with a vision, a lot like myself. He saw something, he wants it real bad, he trains real hard. I'd have to say, 2 out of 3 matches, I'd go with Ron Simmons. And a matter of fact, whoever wins, somewhere down the line, that's my ultimate goal, is to become the world champion myself. And one of the whoever wins is going to have to meet me somewhere down the road.
All right, Bill, a prediction from Bill Kazmaier, going with Ron Simmons. But whoever the champion is, somewhere down the road, must face the world's strongest man. And we'll be back with more on TBS right after this timeout. Welcome back to World Championship Wrestling, everyone. Jim Ross back with you, reminding you still to come our main event. Sting and Beautiful Bobby to take on Cactus Jack and Abdullah the Butcher. That big tag team war still to come here on WCW. And another war that has ensued surrounds the World Tag Team Championship. The enforcers, Arn Anderson and Larry Zbysko, the awesome world champions, are being challenged by the fabulous Freebirds. Recently, at one of our television tapings, our ring announcer, Gary Michael Capetta, found himself in the ring with the enforcers. Well, after what has transpired here on TBS involving the Freebirds and the enforcers and the Screaming Eagles, Anderson and Zbysko had a lot to say. But as you will see, what they said certainly provoked Jimmy Jam Garvin and Michael P.S. Hayes. We're going to take you now back to that piece of videotape. We'll join this situation as Gary Capetta was talking to the enforcers.
Hey, you know, the stupidity of mankind is something that always amazed me. Let me give you a story. A couple hundred years ago, Charles Darwin convinced all you fools that mankind evolved out of some prehistoric, bubbling, scum-infested pile of slime. Now, I always thought that was pretty stupid, like the Patriots thinking they could beat the enforcers. But you know what happened? Along came the Freebirds, and now I'm convinced that there's two slobs that definitely belong in a scum-infested puddle of slime. I have had it up to here with these two long-haired, slimy, stinky idiots, okay? And I'm gonna tell you this. You guys are already on the endangered species list. You mess with us, you guys are gonna be back in that prehistoric mud pit just along with that dodo bird.
You wanna jump us from behind? You wanna come out here with masks on, claiming to be the Screaming Eagles? I'm sick of that whiskey breath. I'm sick of that matted hair, and I'm sick of listening to that song. You want to be rock stars? Do it on your own time. But you stick your head through these ropes. We're not rock stars. We're not movie stars. We're wrestlers. We're the World Tag Team Champions. The next time we see you, if it's at the mall, if it's downtown, if it's getting on a plane, we're going to point out to you firsthand the difference between Freebirds and the World Tag Team Champions.
Well, here are the Freebirds, Garvin and Hayes. And obviously, this rivalry has spilled over here in Montgomery, Alabama. Boy, to say these four guys hate each other is an understatement. The Freebirds want the tag team titles. Hayes rammed shoulder first into the ring post. Garvin and Hayes back in there. And, he's getting a chair. He's got the, look out! He went right for his head. Hayes came back with a left hand. Man, this is a war. An impromptu brawl. Anderson up and over. The Freebirds and the enforcers. The next time they meet, not only what a grudge match, but the tag team titles will be on the line as well. The referees need to get out here. There's Doug Dillinger, but we need some more security up here. Anderson back dropped on the floor. What a chaotic situation. The Freebirds and the Enforcers. Fans, we've got to take a break.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following special ladies contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, to my left, from Stone Mountain, Georgia, weighing 137 pounds, Bambi. Her opponent from Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, weighing 168 pounds, Judy Martin.
Judy Martin, a real tough veteran to take on Bambi here. And you fans have asked for more ladies wrestling, and we saw last week one of the most impressive female athletes that I've ever seen in Medusa. And Judy Martin and Bambi, two other tremendous lady competitors here. And because you fans have asked for it, the WCW promoters are signing more ladies matches on some of these cards. Bambi's an outstanding competitor. Really a local favorite here at center stage. She's from Stone Mountain, Georgia. Judy Martin being hammered, and Bambi now going for the cover. She's on the lateral press and got two out of it, a near fall situation. We certainly hope you fans will join us tomorrow at 6. The final word before Halloween Havoc will be on the TBS main event. And we've got a great broadcast for you tomorrow night. Be sure and tune in. There's a whip to the corner. And Bambi just met the less than petite feet of Judy Martin, and she just missed the elbow. Bambi again going for the lateral press, and the veteran from Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, able to kick out. Well, Medusa has struck twice, very mysteriously. We don't really know what her objectives or her motivation for being here in WCW, other than the obvious competition. But there's got to be more to it than meets the eye, and I'm going to be talking with her a little bit later in this broadcast. Bambi showing surprising strength, slamming her larger opponent, going for a splash, but she didn't hit it that time. That was a veteran move by Martin to pull the knees up. And a headbutt to the abdomen. Our main event on tap, Sting and beautiful Bobby to take on Cactus Jack and Abdullah the Butcher. At our feature attraction here on TBS and WCW. And now Judy Martin has Bambi in a very precarious situation and slams her very uniquely. On top. And Bambi, who's giving away a significant amount of poundage here. Wouldn't want Judy Martin to hear that, but Bambi is smaller. Martin's really tough. We saw her longtime tag team partner, Leilani Kai, here last week. They've been great tag team champions over the years. Wrestled internationally. And there's a sunset flip and got two. Mike Atkins almost had the three count there. Inside cradle. And Judy Martin just too strong for that move. Snap suplex. That hurt her right there. She may be out, but she kicked out. A lot of resiliency in this young lady from Stone Mountain, Georgia. I want to remind the fans that this Friday night, WCW will be in beautiful Albuquerque, New Mexico, at the Tingley Coliseum. I want to say a special hello to our fans in Albuquerque. Hope you'll be with us this Friday night. First WCW live event in Albuquerque in quite some time. It's this Friday night at 8 o'clock. Bambi fires up with the right hand, but not sure what effect that had on Judy Martin at this point in time in the match. I know when I was refereeing in professional wrestling, I hated to referee these girls' matches. They're so unpredictable, and they're just as volatile as a man. Judy Martin using the hair there. So I don't envy Mike Atkins at all for this assignment. But well placed in the throat. Martin with a forearm to the back. Saw Theodore Long earlier today. He's got Johnny B. Bad ready for Halloween Havoc. And we'll see Johnny B. Bad a little bit later in the broadcast. Judy Martin with a full head of steam. Found nothing but turnbuckle there. Now let's see if Bambi can recoup and generate some offense. A couple of clotheslines, put Big Judy down. Lateral press, and Martin got the shoulder up. Again, Bambi going for the pin. She got the other shoulder up this time. Love to be in Albuquerque Friday night. Oh, a beautiful part of the country there. At Kingley Coliseum, great facility to watch WCW action. And our promoter, David Crockett, lets me know that there are some great seats still available for that event for our fans in the Albuquerque area. Just nothing like seeing WCW action live. Our fans are enjoying it here at Center Stage, where we'll return on Monday, November the 4th. That's Monday, November 4th, back here at Center Stage. But if you get the opportunity, whether it be in Chattanooga, Tennessee tomorrow night, or 1 week from tonight in Cleveland, this Friday in Albuquerque, wherever it may be in this great land of ours, hope you'll take your family to see great sports excitement from WCW. Right now, Bambi probably not too excited about what is going on in the ring at the hands of Judy Martin. And she's got her waist up. Atomic drop. But she didn't use her knees. She used the canvas and took her all the way down. And a modified bulldog. She may have her here. And she's hooked the leg. And Bambi wins it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match is Bambi.
There's Medusa. And Medusa with a karate kick and a clothesline. She knocked Judy Martin out of the ring. Judy's leaving. Smart girl, and now she's taking care of Bambi. Wow. What a complex individual is Medusa. And we're going to be talking to her in a moment. And Bambi fights back, knocks Medusa down. The referees are out there. Well, I've got an interview scheduled. I don't know. I'm not as excited about it as I was before we went on the air, to be quite honest about it. Referee trying to restrain Bambi as we take another look. She got that bulldog and got the pin. 1, 2, 3. We'll get the ladies separated here, then I'll talk to Medusa. I must say that your actions the last couple of weeks here on TBS have been very unpredictable, and I know that the fans are wondering, what is your objectives here in World Championship Wrestling? What is your motivation?
Motivation? Mr. Ross, I have respect for you. Just shush up 1 minute. I am the first lady of WCW. In fact, I am professional wrestling. If that means I have to demolish every valet, Ms. Blossom. If that means I have to demolish every valet and every manager, Miss York, and every wannabe, Miss Commentator, Miss Missy Hyatt, I will, and then some. And that means I will kick some ass.
Well, I think you got the drift. She wants to be the First Lady of World Championship Wrestling. I'm not going to argue with her. We'll be back with Johnny B. Badd.
It is set for one fall. Introducing first, the godfather of World Championship Wrestling, Theodore R. Long, proudly presents from Macon, Georgia, weighing 238 pounds, Johnny B. Badd. His opponent from Chicago, Illinois, weighing 225 pounds, Rex King.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Rex King making his WCW debut against Johnny B. Badd. And Johnny B. Badd, one of over 30 stars that have signed to compete in WCW at Halloween Havoc. Somewhat taken aback, so to speak, my interview with Medusa. And obviously, Lady Blossom, Alexandra York, any female wrestlers, and even Missy Hyatt better not relax with Medusa around. The fans have a great time with Johnny B. Badd, whether you love the guy or you hate him. He is certainly flamboyant. So now we know Medusa's objective. That is to be the First Lady of WCW. Watch the hands of this guy. Man, what a... He's got great hands. I've never been around anybody in the sport in my career that have such dynamic hands as Johnny B. Badd. One of my boyhood heroes, the legendary Danny Hodge from Oklahoma, was a National Golden Gloves boxing champion, but he didn't have the hands that Johnny B. Badd possesses. This guy's got a dynamic left, as you'll see right here in this warm-up. Peanut Head's got those catcher's gloves on. Left hook. And Rex King, who's a very highly regarded athlete, very patiently waiting Johnny B. Badd and Theodore there to finish their pre-match festivities. Fans, hope you'll join us if you're in the Cleveland, Ohio area. For all of our great fans up in Cleveland, WCW in Cleveland, 1 week from tonight. That's on Saturday, November the 2nd at the Convention Center. Big lineup in Cleveland. Hope you'll be there with us if you're in the area. That's 1 week from tonight. 8 o'clock in Cleveland at the Convention Center. Test of strength here in the early going. Johnny B. Badd had the advantage momentarily. Nice move there by Rex King. And Johnny B. Badd came right back to a wrestling move, the front face lock. He's not going to get too fancy. Front face lock into a suplex. Rex King tried to dazzle Johnny B. Badd with a little bit of high-flying tactics. Johnny B. Badd stayed grounded, stayed focused. There's a power slam. And you could hear Peanut Head out here shouting his commands to Johnny B. Badd. Interesting move here. Unique slam, almost into a suplex position. Lateral press, and King able to kick out that time. Johnny B. Badd just having a good time right now. Standing drop kick from the former 5 times Empire State amateur boxing champion. All I wonder what the guys up at the station house think of Johnny B. Babb, because his dad is a New York City police officer. And he is hammering. For the lack of a better illustration, don't be misled by his flamboyance. This is a tough athlete. He's well conditioned.
All I want you to do right now, Johnny, is stay right on him and let him know you're a bad man.
Well, Theodore's making his intentions known, doing a little coaching there at ringside. Theodore can coach the offense. Maybe he needs to coach the Falcons. Johnny B. Babb, a very offensive-minded athlete. The point of the elbow, right in chest. And again, Johnny B. Babb had the lateral press. Someday this will come back to haunt him. Could be right here. Flying clothesline on Rex King. Fans, if you just joined us, our main event is still to come. Cactus Jack and Abdullah the Butcher to take on Sting and Beautiful Bobby. And there's that high knee. He caught that kid right in the head with that high knee. And Rex King now is even having trouble standing. His equilibrium is shot. And there's a left hand. Johnny B. Babb and his left hand to take on Jimmy Jim Garvin at Halloween Havoc.
Here's your winner, Johnny B. Babb.
Johnny B. Babb, as is customary after his victory, will put what he calls the kiss of death on his opponent. The kiss that don't miss. And the left hand doesn't miss either. You watch it yourself, right here. Boom. Fans, the Young Pistols are coming up. But first, I'd like to take you to this week's WCW Top 10.
Here's a look at the WCW Top 10 rankings and singles competition as compiled by promoters and members of the WCW Board of Directors for the weekend of Saturday, October 26th. In the number 10 spot for the second week in a row, the computerized man of the 1990s, Terrence Taylor. The number 9 man in this week of the Top 10 is the dog-faced gremlin Rick Steiner. The number 8 man up one spot from last week from Macon, Georgia, Johnny B. Babb. In at number 7 this week, the former World Television Champion, Beautiful Bobby. Up one spot to number 6 from Truth or Consequences, New Mexico, Cactus Jack. And the top 5 remains the same from last week. The number 5 man, the natural Dustin Rhodes. Number 4, World TV Champ, Stunning Steve Austin. And number 3, Barry Windham. In at number 2, All-American Ron Simmons. And the number 1 ranked contender, the U.S. Heavyweight Champion, Sting. And of course, the WCW World Heavyweight Champion is the total package, Lex Luger.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following tag team event, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Wyoming, Steve Tracy, the Young Pistols. Their opponents, total combined weight, 454 pounds. From the State Patrol, Sergeant Buddy Lee Parker. From Tampa, Florida, Rick King.
Fans, while we have a moment, I want to remind you that you can enjoy the action here at Center Stage if you'll be with us on Monday, November the 4th. Monday, November 4th, 7 o'clock starting time. We'll be back here at Center Stage for another of our national television tapings. Steve and Tracy, the Young Pistols. Probably the most offensive-minded tag team in WCW. They take a lot of chances. Right now, they're in there with double tough Sergeant Buddy Lee Parker. Parker missed the clothesline. Cross body, he's got the leg hooked and got two out of it. Arm drag takeover. Not treating the former State patrolman very respectfully here. Good move there by Tracy. Great rights. Overhand rights. Side headlock. Good shoulder block by Sergeant Buddy Lee Parker. And a hip lock by Tracy, able to kick out of a pinning predicament, and a good drop toe hold. And Tracy, the young pistol, is in the hammerlock. I was talking to my good friend Sheriff Pat Jarvis over in DeKalb County, and he assures me that Sergeant Buddy Lee Parker has never been a member of the DeKalb County Police Force. I don't know where Parker was a police officer, but wherever it was, I'm sure they're not going to want to admit it anyway. But we know it wasn't in DeKalb County. Arm bar applied back into the hammerlock. Irish whip. And Sergeant Parker takes Tracy straight down. Sergeant Parker looking tough here. He's got the leg hooked and got a near fall out of it. There's the exchange now. Good drop toe hold. Half Nelson to a pinning predicament. Perpetual offense. These kids are always moving, the young pistols. I'll tell you something, that since that announcement last week that Mr. Hughes would be barred from ringside and that Dusty Rhodes does have a manager's license for one night only, I really think that with a 2 out of 3 fall stipulation that Ron Simmons, I know he's mentally ready. We know that he is physically ready for the match of his life. You know, Simmons played in 2 Orange Bowls. He knows what it's like to get in a big match environment. And I can tell you that there's no greater fans in the world than those that you will see on pay-per-view tomorrow night in the UTC Arena. They are great sports fans, and they're going to have an exciting atmosphere tomorrow night that I think will have a positive effect on Ron Simmons. Tracy with that arm bar, and Sergeant Parker, the kick from behind. Serving really to frustrate Tracy a little bit. He's going to retaliate with a right hand. Luger, I was privileged to watch one of his workouts this week. They did not allow any cameras there. Let me tell you something. That was a great double drop kick. Luger is a machine. 6'5", 292. I don't know what his body fat content is, but I said in the gym it was around 7%. Which is uncanny for a man with that size. Sergeant Buddy Lee Parker taking a look. Luger and Simmons, 2 out of 3 falls. I'm very happy, and I've been guilty of maligning the WCW Championship Committee for some of their decisions. But I think it's probably one of the smartest things they have done to sign that match with 2 out of 3 falls, because either athlete has the opportunity to make a mistake. Oh, man, what a move. And rebound from it. Regroup. Great karate kick there by Tracy. Good move. Good takedown. Back into the wrist lock. I know Ron's teammates, former teammates, we should say, former coaches down at Florida State. There's any doubt in anybody's mind that they're not the greatest team in college football, and I don't know what we got to show you to convince you. They're an awesome machine down in Tallahassee, and he's feeding on that. He's feeding on their success. They're feeding on his success. Ron Simmons has served as a great motivating factor for the Florida State Seminoles in this season, and the young Pistols taking advantage of the referee, quite frankly. They made 2 exchanges with no tags. Hey, they're competitors. They are more than willing at any time to wrestle the Patriots, who are 2 of their buddies for the United States tag titles. They'd like to have the opportunity, as the Patriots will have tomorrow night, to take on the Enforcers for the World Tag titles. This young team has been very, very close on many occasions to winning their first major tag team championship. Good focus here. We haven't seen them fly and take as many chances here. Maybe they're changing their strategy a little bit in this contest from what we have seen in the past. Fans, don't forget that I'll have my predictions on the wrestling hotline until 9 o'clock tonight on tomorrow night's Halloween Havoc event. At 9, I'll turn it over to Gordon Solie and Lance Russell for a very special Halloween Havoc preview show. That'll start at 9 o'clock Eastern tonight. And then live coverage of the Halloween Havoc event will be on the hotline. So if you got several ways to be involved in it, be in Chattanooga or call your local cable company or pick up your telephone and be a part of it on the wrestling hotline. 3-point stance by Tracy, former outstanding athlete from Carson Newman. A real NAIA power in college football. Tag made. Steve in there now. Steve Armstrong. Tracy up on the top. Sergeant Parker on top as well. And Parker came off first. And there's the elbow on Sergeant Buddy Lee Parker. He's all knocked all the way out to the floor. Irish whip to the center of the ropes, a waist lock, and watch the extension on this drop kick. Tremendous drop kick by Steve, and the Young Pistols are winning it here.
Here are your winners, Steve, Tracy, the Young Pistols.
Steve and Tracy, the Young Pistols, very popular here at center stage, and they've just won this tag team event. Now, still to come, Sting and Beautiful Bobby to meet Cactus Jack and Abdullah the Butcher. That's still to come in this hour. We've got the drop kick right here. First it was a waist lock. Steve, watch a great extension. The placement of the feet, boom, right there in the heart. Knocks the breath out of the opponent. The Young Pistols are winners, and our dynamic tag team war is next.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following tag team event, it is set for one fall. Introducing team number one from Truth or Consequences, New Mexico. Weighing 282 pounds, Cactus Jack. His partner from the Sudan, weighing 460 pounds, Abdullah the Butcher.
Fans, I want to remind you that tomorrow on the main event, it'll be Cactus Jack and heavy metal Van Hammer. That one of our feature events. Plus, I'll be talking to Ron Simmons, that and much more tomorrow, 6:05 on TBS.
And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents. First, from Huntsville, Alabama, 230.
Beautiful Bobby and the Stinger making their way to the ring in a big-time hurry. Both these men have major scores to settle with their opponents. We have seen some very violent altercations involving these four. All the way back, beginning at the Clash of Champions back in September. Sting kneeing Cactus Jack, knocking him outside. Beautiful Bobby trying to make an impression on Abdullah the Butcher. And, oh, he's, my God, he's backdropped all the way down the rampway there. Nothing but wood. Nothing to break his fall at all. Cactus Jack backdropped out of sight, and Abdullah with a karate on Beautiful Bobby Eaton. Sting now, I don't even know where that door leads to. That exit is not used. Perhaps it's just a fire exit here at center stage. Cactus being taken up and over. Sting coming back in. Sting and Abdullah both will be in the Chamber of Horrors steel cage match at Halloween Havoc tomorrow night, and I think that's going to be quite simply a bloodbath in that cage. Oh, Beautiful Bobby with those tremendous right hands back in Cactus into the corner, but it was Cactus with a kick to the midsection. Fans, don't forget we have our predictions right now on the wrestling hotline. Last minute injury reports. Things about Halloween Havoc we can't say right here on television. And Lance Russell and Gordon Solie have a Halloween Havoc preview at 9 tonight. Nice headbutt. The Dean of Wrestling Broadcasters, Gordon Solie. And the outstanding broadcaster from Memphis, Lance Russell, tonight at 9 on the hotline. Beautiful Bobby now being double teamed. And here comes the United States Heavyweight Champion, the Stinger. Referee Nick Patrick's got to put Sting outside. And Cactus Jack drops the knee. He's on a lateral press. But Beautiful Bobby able to kick out. What a matchup. To close this broadcast out, straight down, face first, goes Beautiful Bobby. And again, Cactus got a two count out of it. Remember, you can be a part of Halloween Havoc by being with us live in the UTC Arena in Chattanooga, or by listening to it on the Wrestling Hotline, and of course by calling your local cable company and ordering this tremendous event. Sharp lefts by Cactus and Beautiful Bobby. Big challenge, and what a right hand. Cactus Jack and eating both up and over the top. Abdullah quickly down. Beautiful Bobby in almost a lion's den here. I think Cactus Jack and Abdullah should be dispatched to Minneapolis. That'd be great bat boys for the Twins. That would certainly disrupt their focus tonight against the Braves. Beautiful Bobby. His head was just rammed into the skull of Abdullah. Abdullah the karate thrust. And Abdullah doesn't mind the Clarent flowing. And that's what I think will happen in that Chamber of Horrors steel cage match. They pull in the eye. Come on, ref. Disqualify these guys, but you got to get control when Cactus Jack and Abdullah are together. And I know it's challenging for the official. Look at those kicks right to the head.
That's it.
Nick Patrick's doing the best job he can, but what a challenge for the senior referee in WCW. But Beautiful Bobby, nice counter move. He caught Cactus coming in with that elbow. Tossed outside. Cactus, watch him on the apron. He went for that big 360 move, but he found nothing but floor. Beautiful Bobby able to move out of the way. Now can he tag the Stinger? That's what he needs to do. And he does. Sting in, hammering away, but he's just snuffed out. But he keeps trying to fight back. I thought Abdullah had him snuffed out with that karate thrust. It's a butcher from behind. But Sting, the adrenaline rush. And a stun gun maneuver. Trying to go for the pin right there. One. But Abdullah is. It's getting obviously very chaotic and out of control here. Abdullah with a karate thrust. And Beautiful Bobby is going to be pinned. Karate right to the throat. What a war it'll be in the cage at Halloween Havoc tomorrow night. And Cactus practice now with a kendo stick. Fans, we're about out of time. For our whole crew, I'm Jim Ross. We'll see you in the main event tomorrow.